Jesus, our model of service. Again, a reminder to light a candle and pause for the grace that will be given. This reflection is a powerful one. I ask you to please take it to heart. Jesus lives his life in the service of others. Open the gospel to any page and you will find Jesus doing something for someone. He is forgiving sins, healing diseases, freeing people from what limits them, feeding a crowd, calming a storm, teaching or answering questions, inviting or encouraging someone. He boldly confronts religious and political leaders. This too is in the interest of suffering people. His outstanding human quality is his concern. He feels others' pain and devotes himself to easing it. Indeed, his dedication to God seems to consist chiefly in this total commitment to the well-being of the human community. There's something remarkable about the scope of his love. Most people love someone, but Jesus had a heart large enough to embrace everyone. In closing, I'm reminded of a time when our Pope Francis was ordaining 8 men. They lay prostrate before him. He asked them to look up at the 4 exit signs. He said it is very important to come to church and make our needs known to God, but what's every bit as important is to exit. Then he said, "Exit is your holy word. Go out to the people being equipped with every grace needed." And I say to us, let us take this holy word exit to heart by saying, "Here I am, Lord," praying to see with your eyes and loving with your heart. Amen. Amen.